and I hold it again like this. I hug my bags and then I close it up. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, to my little corner of the internet where we talk about luxury designer handbags. So I'm already apologizing if you might hear some noises today. There's a lot of construction work going on, like two houses down the street. And yeah, just so that you know where it's coming from. Okay, so today's video is all about my five best and my five worst luxury purchases. So for me, it's always pretty easy. If I really do not like one of my purchases, I am selling it. And I'm most of the time trying to, if it's a bag, take the bag out one more time and see if I really like it or if I've fallen out of love with it. And if it's like a jewelry piece, I basically do the same. You know, and if I don't get the butterflies anymore, then I think most of the time it's not worth keeping the item anymore. I'd rather sell it then and invest it into another piece that makes my heart sing. So I'm gonna go through all of this today in no particular order. So I'm just gonna always do like a best one and a worst one, a best worst. So this is my beautiful Louis Vuitton comeback in the reverse monogram canvas. And I absolutely love this piece. It was pretty hard to get at the time that this bag came out. It was like one of these really, really hot items and everybody wanted to get their hands on it. And there was like a 3 months wait time, but my SA actually made it happen that I don't know how she did it, but I got it basically in 3 days. But there's a whole story about my comeback and I'm still gonna do that story time video soon because I had to go through 3 comebacks to get this one, a perfect one. So I'm pretty happy that I have this one in my collection. I think it's such a stunning piece. It's just not your regular handbag, right? I mean, the shape is unique. The color combination, I think, is absolutely unique. So I've been loving this bag since the day I've got it. And I just really like styling it. With a lot of different outfits. Most of the time I actually do prefer to wear this bag just like handheld or on the crook of my arm, but you do have the option of actually attaching a shoulder strap if you wanted to. However, you have to balance that bag out, otherwise it tends to like do that. When it comes to opening and closing this bag, you have to get used to it a little bit. Like what I always do and what I think is the easiest way to do this actually is you hold your bag basically like a little bag baby and then you open it up and then there you can see the shoulder strap as well. It has like a black microfiber lining inside, and then I hold it again like this. I hug my bags and then I close it up. So that's the only thing that you have to take into consideration when buying this bag. It's not as easy to get into this bag as maybe with other bags. But yeah, definitely one of my greatest picks, so I can only recommend this one. Okay, let's do a worst purchase. So many years ago when I like started collecting designer handbags, I've been collecting them for 8 years now, and I really wanted to have an Hermès bag. I mean, everybody does, right? And so I bought this vintage Kelly, and it was from 1970s, from the 1970s. I think it was actually from 1970, or was it 1972? I can't really remember, but like around that area. So it was old, like the oldest bag I've probably ever seen on the pre-loved market, like in person. And I found it in one of the vintage shops here in London, and I was like, yeah, it was an amazing price for a Kelly. It was like £1,800 or something, but I mean, let's take into consideration how old this bag was. It was black box carved, gold hardware, very beautiful bag. I was taking it out quite often and I liked it. However, because it was that old, it actually did fall apart inside. The interior leather lining, it was just breaking apart basically, and it was, yeah, not that nice. I decided to sell it again at some point. I do love the vintage Kelly bags, of course. I've said it several times in my other videos. I really do want to add a vintage box carved Kelly with gold hardware to my collection from my birth year. That would be like the dream. But yeah, I haven't come across the perfect one yet. And I'm pretty sure next time we're gonna go to Japan, I'm gonna find her. Because we've seen so many nice vintage Kelly's there, and they are in absolute amazing condition. Of course, you have to pay the price for it, but yeah, it's definitely on my wish list. Okay, so next up, let's look at this one. So this is my Gucci brooch bag. I've recently done a video on that one. I've basically done a video on all of these bags, so you can go and find individual reviews if you want to. This is like the jewel in my collection, I would say. This is a Gucci brooch bag, and from Alessandro Michele's early time at Gucci. And this has just been such a showstopper. I always, whenever I go to London Fashion Week, I have always been taking this one with me. I've met Daphne Guinness with this bag. So that will always be a really nice memory attached to this bag, of course. And yeah, I mean, what can I say? I think there's nothing out there that's more screaming artwork handbag than this one. I think it's a great conversation starter. You just have to take this bag on the tube, on the bus, walk around with it in London. People are stopping you and asking you what this bag is, where it's from, and so on. So it's pretty nice, and definitely one of my favorite pieces. So I can only say, yeah, this was definitely a best one. Okay, next up, I would say let's talk about my Chanel Gabrielle bag. Well, you can see I do have a Chanel Gabrielle bag in my collection, and we get to that one soon. But I did have, before I got this one, I had a Chanel Gabrielle medium size as well, same one as this one, in the Tweed. It was like an orangey black color, and I did like it, like, aesthetically. However, I was only wearing that bag a couple of times, and the pilling on the back of the bag where it's rubbing against your body, it was horrible. It was absolutely, absolutely terrible to look at it after only wearing it a couple of times, because it looked so worn and it looked so like it would fall apart soon. So I've decided to let that one go before it got even worse. And from that moment onwards, I knew, like, handbags, when it comes to handbags, I wouldn't want to add a second Tweed handbag to my collection ever. I mean, maybe my bag was just, you know, not the best quality, but it just made me really aware of how easy Tweed wears, especially if it's a handbag and you just, you know, have it on your body. And yeah, definitely wasn't a good choice. Okay, next up then, of course, let's talk about my Chanel Gabrielle bag. So I have this beauty in my collection, and I love the Chanel Gabrielle line in general. I mean, I have the backpack as well. And usually I go for like classic styles and silhouettes only. And I know that the Gabrielle obviously is very edgy, so is the boy. But I don't know, when it comes to Chanel, I seem to be drawn towards those bags, and I really enjoy wearing them a lot. Like, I love my Gabrielle bag and my Gabrielle backpack. And so it's just so comfortable. You have so many different ways of how you can wear the bag, and it's a perfect travel bag, perfect city bag, and yeah, I just love it. So yeah, after I've sold my Gabrielle Tweed bag, I was basically looking out for the perfect other Gabrielle bag, and this one I have seen while I already owned the other one, and I was like, this was a seasonal piece. I was like, oh shit, I'm never gonna get my hands on this one again, because it was sold out pretty quickly. And so I waited and waited and waited about 2-3 years until this one popped up on the pre-loved market. And I immediately basically bought it. I bought it from Fashion Fire, and I was like, oh wow, I finally did get my hands on this perfect Gabrielle, because I was looking out, of course, for the perfect Gabrielle throughout all the other seasons, and there was never a bag that has stunned me as much as this one did the first time I saw it when it came into the stores. So yeah, so happy that I was able to still get my hands on this beauty. I mean, sometimes you just have to wait, I feel, with finding your perfect bag. And you know, why settle for anything that you don't love that much? Okay, so next up, I think I would want to mention, I had two Gucci Dionysus bags, and don't ask me why. I don't like silver hardware. The only bags I do have with silver hardware are those two, but they basically come with silver and gold, so I'm fine with it. But yeah, I know, very OCD. But so I did have two Dionysus bags, and they were both in the velvet. One was in the red velvet and the other one was in the green velvet. And so this, the red one was the super mini one, like the tiny, tiny bag that doesn't even fit your smartphone. And the other one was the medium size. And I don't know what has drawn me towards them in the first place. Maybe there's just the fact that it's velvet. But to be honest, I don't know if you do have the velvet Dionysus bags, if you know how they feel like. I do have other Gucci bags, like this one I have, my Maman, which is in the velvet as well. But they feel luxurious when you touch them. They feel luxurious to the touch. And with the Dionysus ones, they felt so flimsy. Like when you were opening up the flaps, they feel so flimsy that you're actually asking yourself, like, did they put cardboard in there? And that was it, basically. It really felt like cardboard that was covered in velvet. And it, yeah. The regular Dionysus bags, like, they feel great, they feel normal, so I think it's only the velvet ones. So the regular GG logo ones feels better. The leather ones, of course, they feel a lot better, but the velvet Dionysus bags, I don't know what it is. It feels very, yeah, flimsy. So I sold both of them and, yeah, never regretted selling them. Okay, so next up is my, ooh, beautiful Chanel Gabrielle backpack, and I've said it before, this is probably my most worn bag ever. Most of the time throughout spring, summer, autumn, I just carry that as an everyday bag, and I love it so much. I would have never thought that I enjoy carrying a backpack that much. I'm not a backpack girl, but when it comes to this one, I couldn't enjoy it more. So, it comes with all four types of hardware. I've done a review on it. You can just go to my channel and find that. But yeah, this one was definitely my best purchase ever. And considering that the all Gabrielle bags do belong to the classic lines, they have constant price increases as well. So they grow in investment as well. And yeah, I couldn't be happier. And I'm so happy that I did add this to my collection at the very beginning when it came out. This was my first Gabrielle bag, basically, and then I got the other one afterwards. And yeah, so really, really happy with this one, and I can only recommend it. I know a lot of my subscribers have actually purchased this bag as well recently, and I'm so happy for you. So definitely let me know once your bags have arrived, how you like them, and so on and so on. One of my subbies has actually got it in the gold. And it's such a stunning bag. I've seen it in one of the pre-loved shops as well, and had I not had this one, I would have probably gotten the gold one as well. So yeah, it's definitely a bag I can only recommend to anyone who's looking for the perfect casual everyday bag that's still chic. So yeah, really happy with this one. Okay, so next up, let's talk about designer custom jewelry. So as you do know, I have an obsession for Chanel earrings. And there was a time when I was really obsessed with, like, everything Dior. Dior necklaces, Dior earrings, everything Dior. So I had this choker from Dior, the Jar Dior choker. I'm gonna put a picture up here. And I loved the look of that accessory. And I was wearing it quite a lot. However, like, I would say I have probably normal sized neck or even on the thinner side, but this choker, they were all one size, so you couldn't, like, pick a different size for a different body, basically. And it was so tight. You felt like every time you were wearing it, you felt like this was actually probably like a dog collar. It was so tight. It was unbelievably uncomfortable to wear this choker, and it's such a shame because I don't know, why are they making it only in one size? And it's probably for the tiniest, little, thinnest model necks. but I mean, regular population has probably different proportions, Dior. No, but I really liked that one aesthetically, but it was very uncomfortable, so I had to sell it again. And yeah, I did have a lot of other Dior earrings and stuff that I sold, but yeah, that was definitely one of my worst purchases. Okay, so last but not least, in terms of best purchases, I mean, people who've seen my Japan shopping vlogs, you probably already know that I found this beautiful Chanel tote bag, and I was looking for a tote bag for so long, and then I found this one, and I couldn't be happier with it. Of course, we're still in lockdown, so I couldn't take it out that much, but even for just like running errands, going to the grocery store, it's the perfect bag. Like, and that's why I can already see how much joy and how much use I actually gonna get out of this once life is back to normal. So it's just this one huge hole, basically. You can throw everything in. It fits so much. It fits more like a Neverfull MM, probably like a Neverfull GM, if we talk in terms of size comparisons. But yeah, definitely one of my best purchases ever. And I'm so happy to have this one. I mean, yeah, I'm someone, if I can, I just carry everything with me. Like, even if it's summer and it's really warm, I probably always just carry, if I can, if I have the space, just a jacket with me, because it might get cold in the evenings. So yeah, love this Chanel tote so much. Yeah, and that brings me to my last point. Whoops, nine. Wait, let's do this. That brings me to my last point, which is the fifth worst purchase. And yeah, that was a pair of Chanel earrings. So I currently only have three pairs of Chanel earrings. I've had a couple more in the past, but you know, if I fall out of love with them, or if they do not fit me well, if they actually hurt, because my ears are very sensitive, then I just sell them as well. And it was this beautiful pair of really, really big pearl earrings that had the CC logo on the front, and they were very hyped, I would say, as well, at a certain point. And I bought them, and I was wearing them, and the first time I already wore them, I took them out in the evening, and I didn't feel anything. Like, at that point, it was not that I was in pain or anything, I didn't feel anything, but I took them out, and my ears were basically bleeding. Yeah, it was not a nice experience. That's why this was probably my worst purchase ever. I then, of course, you don't want to give up, right? You just have a new pair of Chanel earrings. So I was trying to wear them a couple more times, and it was a nightmare every single time, and it made my ears even more sensitive, and after a while it did hurt like hell. So I sold them pretty quickly. And yeah, so now I actually do know as well, like, my earrings have to be, these look maybe like they're really, really long and they might be heavy, but they're not, they're so lightweight. And all of my Chanel earrings that I do have now, they are very lightweight. And those pearls, they were so heavy that they actually were like basically falling down, so it was not like a nice look even. But yeah, so that was it. I think that was my five best purchases and my five worst purchases. So yeah, I hope that you did enjoy this video. Let me know in the comment section down below what are your best and worst purchases. And yeah guys, thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Join our little handbag obsessed family here, because we all do have the same luxury disease. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I see you guys soon. Bye!